All right, thanks, Tony. Developing news now in a lawsuit mistake that could end up costing Rhode Island taxpayers millions of dollars.
And tonight, the lawyer being blamed for the costly oversight is stepping down.
Eyewitness News reporter Steph Machado joins us live now with the developing details.
The attorney being blamed for this mistake has now resigned, his supervisor placed on leave as the state investigates what went wrong here.
There's no question that this was a significant lapse.
Health and Human Services Secretary Eric Bean responding after his office failed to file an appeal in time for a deadline in a nursing home lawsuit. The mistake could cost taxpayers $24 million. It's being blamed on now former staff attorney Gregory Hazian.
This type of behavior will not be tolerated.
In court filings asking a judge for an extension on the appeal, the Executive Office of Health and Human Services says Hazian was in charge of the lawsuit filed by 59 nursing homes against the state over Medicaid rate cuts. A judge ruled for the nursing homes, and the court filing says Hazian was notified of the state's deadline to appeal, but quote, he deleted critical court notifications from his work computer that could have alerted EOHHS to these events. He resigned Monday under threat of termination. Bean says he wasn't even aware this lawsuit was still pending.
Why aren't there more people tracking its progress to make sure that these deadlines are met?
That's part of what we're looking into in this investigation. A case of this significance should have been much more broadly disclosed to leadership.
Virginia Burke, who represents the nursing homes, says regardless of this snafu, the state owes them this money.
Whether they made the appeal deadline or not, the fact is this is money that is owed to these facilities, and they need it. They need these resources to take care of the elderly.
And that attorney, Greg Hazian, was actually removed from the master role of attorneys earlier this year, but the state says they were never notified. He declined to comment today. Now, Governor Gina Raimondo issued a statement last night saying she was deeply disappointed and frustrated, but she did not speak to reporters today. Coming up new at 6, what her political opponents are saying about all this. Live in Cranston, I'm Steph Machado, Eyewitness News.
First, developing news on a costly mistake by the state that could leave Rhode Island taxpayers on the hook for millions.
We first reported on the missed court deadline yesterday, which state officials called an egregious error. But the state Republican Party claims the blame for this mistake starts at the top. Eyewitness News reporter Steph Machado begins our team coverage now, live in Cranston.
Well, Governor Raimondo's political opponents pounced on this mistake, calling for firings. But the state says it's the fault of a lawyer here at the Executive Office of Health and Human Services.
This type of behavior will not be tolerated.
Executive Office of Health and Human Services Secretary Eric Bean says it was a staff attorney, Gregory Hazian, who failed to file an appeal to a nursing home lawsuit in time for the deadline, a mistake that could cost taxpayers $24 million.
I did not know that this case was still pending, no.
Bean says Hazian, who has now resigned, and his supervisor, who's been placed on leave, should have kept Bean in the loop about the suit. Instead, court filings say Hazian, quote, deleted critical court notifications from his work computer that could have alerted EOHHS to these events.
Heads need to roll.
Brandon Bell, the chairman of the Rhode Island Republican Party, seized on the moment to attack Raimondo and her administration in an election year.
It's absolute incompetence. It's not looking out for the taxpayers. And this is something that the governor has been her signature.
Raimondo said last night she was disappointed and frustrated with what happened. Now, we've been asking her office since this morning to speak to her for this story. They initially said she'd be unavailable today, but just in the last 20 minutes, they did schedule a news conference at the State House with the governor. My colleague Kim Kalunian is there, and we'll bring you what the governor has to say at 6:30 over on Fox Providence. Live in Cranston, I'm Steph Machado, Eyewitness News.